From News 8 WMTW-TV, this is a News 8 NOW update.
Welcome back to News 8 NOW. I'm Tracy Sable. A popular dance among teenagers is raising some eyebrows, and several local schools are trying to crack down on it. It's called grinding, a provocative dance which involves partners holding each other extremely close. In Windham, school officials say it is such a problem they will no longer sponsor any dances except for prom. Students say they want to be able to dance however they want, but administrators say they need to protect students and prevent inappropriate and unwanted contact. Thursday night, administrators sat down with students and parents to talk about the issue, the first in what is expected to be a series of meetings. The goal is to work out some kind of compromise that will allow school dances in the future.
I think it should still, not grinding necessarily, but it's still dancing. Like we dance, like we learn to dance. There's really only one type of dancing, but it doesn't have to be as extreme. It doesn't have to be as sexual or, just back off a little bit, but still how we learn to dance.
When they are as close as they are in that physical contact, it's really hypersexualized. It sends the wrong message to our boys. It tells them if they want to dance with a girl that they essentially have to press themselves against them. And for our girls, it really objectifies them. And it's 2010. That's not the image I want for my kids.
Now, some students say if the school won't sponsor the dances, they will simply take them elsewhere, like rent a dance halls where they can dance however they want. Students have put together a committee to discuss the issue and come up with ideas to bring to administrators. Another meeting about grinding is scheduled for next Monday. A judge granting a restraining order Thursday against the town of Ogunquit requested by town selectman Michael Score. That means the select board will not meet Friday to determine what, if any, action should be taken against Score, who's accused of violating the town charter. A resident and a local business owner last month accused Score, who was also running for District House seat 149, of using his title as public official to influence citizens. An independent investigator determined that Score's actions did violate the town charter. Score contends that the charter is unconstitutional, and so any action against him would be without merit. We tried to reach town officials for comment on the ruling, but our calls were not returned. In Biddeford, the issue stealing most of the headlines now is a proposal to allow a racino in town. In an effort to make sure residents know as much as possible before voting, the city mayor, along with a representative from Biddeford Downs, is holding a series of meetings next week to answer questions. The meetings are from 5 to 6 in the evening, but you will have to schedule an appointment first. And if you'd like to take part or stop by the Biddeford mayor's office. The Westbrook mayor and city manager tells News 8 that they plan to recommend to the city council that the city pay to renovate the Walker Memorial Library and not move it. The work is expected to cost between $1.2 and $2 million, but town leaders say moving the library would cost even more. The city council will vote on the proposal in a couple of weeks. Now, thanks for joining us here on News 8 NOW. I'm Tracy Sable. Stay with us for the latest weather and sports highlights. We'll be right back.